Welcome everyone to Far Finger Gaming. So we are back Mist. We are presently trying to rescue my friends, Glenn Farfinger and Curly Joe. Unfortunately, I have to unravel the mysteries of this planet, and you notice that we're not really reading the book. I think you caught me at a bit of a disadvantage, if you will. A disadvantage. I don't like to be at a disadvantage. But, Jamie, oh no. But, we barely. Hold on a second here. My setup here. Oh, jeez. Oh, Jamie. What the heck is going on here? We gotta figure this whole setup here. Okay. Let's see here. Enjoyed stars from it. Much sturdier platform than the jagged rocks and the coolest of destruction. I must warn you that with audacity, this is probably not absolutely syncing up right. It's not syncing up right, so a lot of this won't make any sense. You can obviously read what you see on your screen at home.
Well, my worms, you can't read it. Oh, that's so terrible.
But we'll do our best. This person's speed reading. Film phone. This is not a very good playthrough if you have to force people to read. Struck soon, I think that may be in my pride. Okay. We are apparently not speed reading. Let's see here. I returned with many tools that I need for construction of the lighthouse. I decided that once the lighthouse is completed, it would lose some time. In the world's own imagination here, control, I have worked 3 weeks on the lighthouse and now are making great progress.
You dirty champagne! I didn't read that! Oh, Jamie, he turned the page!
Well, we're just gonna have to read very randomly. Let's see here. The lighthouse is finished, and that we are proud of our creation. That the boys are amazed at that they construct from rock with their own hands. The evening powered up the generator, and much to the boys' dread at first, and shined a great light into the horizon for the many hours I staged the night at the top of the lighthouse. That was none of our business. Change the page. We got a map here. Stone Ship Age. Okay, never mind. Not ready to read yet. Gotta look it up. Gotta look it down. Look it up. Look it across. That's right. It's look it across. Okay, this age is a gift to myself that I will wrap up, and even someday in the future, only to discover that it has changed not much. And surprised, besides, I have yet another new age to awaits me. It seems I'm going to need some way to travel underwater. In this new age, as much planning is in order. It has been 10 years since I left this age, which I have since called the Stone Ship Age. Upon returning, I am not, believe, I cannot believe, that, okay, never mind. In perfect condition, it looks as if they have tried their very best to keep it, so lot. I have noted that the entire rock that it was built is approximately 40 to 50 centimeters. After a wonderful visit. Now we got a bunch of, so these are, if you remember, out in the main courtyard. These are the symbols out in the main courtyard. And you'll notice they are astronomical symbols. That's right. Now of course we just spent, we gotta do more reading. Please, no more reading. We should be doing things. We should be doing puzzles, and here's more things, and we're really gonna do this, aren't we? We're really gonna do this. Arriving this age, I was determined that would be a journey to the world very different from my precious adventures, and it was. The sky here is dark and gray, incessantly displays flashes of lightning in the distance. I am not a very old man, with a long beard and and hair that hangs to his waist. He is very feeble and has trouble even moving. The man has distinctly been through there is through many things in this strange world, and I have learned many things from him, and they have told me interesting things. Okay, never mind. As the time passed, friendly resistors brought rumors. I may as well read, folks. I mean, there isn't much else to do. I mean, I don't got really much to talk about, so. Let's see if we're forfeit enough to happen one day, being visually sunny sky, it was so dark as night, steps appeared on the horizon, points, attempts at peace were turned away, and the sentries there were easily overwhelmed. Her ships continued to wreak havoc on the city, apparently destroying everyone and everything. After the foundations of the city were destroyed, a city in the deep into the ocean, only with a lookout passed and remained, and then the black ships sailed away. The man, he continued, okay, never mind, remaining survivors today, and I begin work on plan for protection. After a short distance, I returned to the age with my two sons, and there you have some of great traveled rarely with me, and they are understandably excited to be here. They have grown considerably since ever. What is that word? And it has obvious to be that they have been a great help. My sons have been spending much of their spare time on the Self Island, for most of my materials are stored. I am very pleased with their intelligence and their creativity. It is refreshing to see some of the great small projects of their own. For 4 months now, the construction is going well. My sons love the world except for the gray sky. They detest the gray sky. They don't. Okay. It has in the months of work and finally finished my fortress. It rests between the three hills, which only the islands do for resting, rising of water level. And that the purple people experience after the attack. Besides the fortress, I have designed a most upbringing called a holography. Being an experiment with my results in Abramore a couple of days, I got compensate for some small miscalculations. The holographic device is being learned to see the fortress. The enemy is due to soon the fortress and provide sufficient protection for all of us. You know, more of the stone fortress? That's right. The black ships have come their attack. They're substantial. Their weapons have been stopped, and it appears they have turned away in defeat. I could not help but make I watched the louts leave. I don't know if I'm saying that right. Last night we had a small celebration, and the old survivors danced their dances of old. My sons did not understand why the sky had not turned black. Turned back to its... Okay, never mind. For Billy Age, in search of a new universe, I have begun. But first, I have an extended time with Catherine, for whom I miss very much. I must also return to the purple of the tide. I believe in my travels I have found a substance that will ease the pain of their home and ailments that have endured, and hope to return to... Okay, never return again. Apparently. Oh, worms, they don't return. Not another book! Well, what is this? Is this Reading Rainbow? Reading Rainbow. It's Reading Rainbow. Reading Rainbow. Eye in the sky, as far as I can see. Okay, that I need a Mountain Dew after that one, folks. That was a lot of reading. I can see why Dark Milo picked this one for me. It goes very well with the kind of mind I have, and fortunately we may be here a very long time if I can't figure all this out, which is probably his plan. He's probably banking on all this, you know. So now we're going to take a look out at the island, and of course what ends up happening is that you know, we have to manipulate that. It sort of activates very specific areas of the map. Of course, and there's 240, 221. That's clearly and you see a key sign. Clearly, this is... You can see this all has to do with various parts of the island. And we are going to head back down. A nice little elevator here. Very vintage elevators. You know, very autistic people, really. There are some people, they just absolutely love their elevators. I remember a channel on YouTube where someone was obsessed with escalators. I don't know what to think about that, but each to their own. Each to their own. So now we must adjust this and adjust it well and get it to what we need it at, you know, here, folks. And you see, you know, that what you highlighted, it turns red. You know, that shows that you're in the right place. And if it's white, nope, you're not there, and you gotta get things just right. And clearly we have to unlock the secrets of Mist. We gotta head back up. So what we did is we moved the tower. What has just happened is we've moved the tower so that we can get clear sight. And you can see the numbers changed. So what has happened is all that reading really tired my throat out. So what has happened is we are changing the coordinates of the tower, and it's given us various coordinate numbers. And this is all, I love this little hallway. Nice wood paneling. And so, now we're heading down here, now taking a left here to this little cabin here, and there's coordinates here. We will take those coordinates here. And that opens the safe. It's right. We open the safe. Now we turn that on. Now, of course, we're going to play with this and get this thing just right. Of course, we got to get it to a very specific level. I'm not entirely sure. Okay, maybe that did it. there you go. We got a new elevator. Inside this sort of wooden tree here, you know, and
It's getting kind of dark now. Jamie, where are we going?
This is very kind of gloomy, kind of grim. We are down here in this like little boathouse area here. I think I may have even had a dream about something like this at one point. Now we open a book, and inside the book is a kind of a vision. Open it up again, and it's showing, we're entering a
Jamie, where are we?
Folks, appears we are in the middle of a swamp area here. Hope we don't run into the swamp thing, you know what I mean? we'll head this way and okay. So we are got to remember everything we remember from those books, you know, that they give indications about everything. So we're heading over here. It looks like a pump house of some kind. And, let's see. Looks like they kind of stopped the pump house. I don't know. Let's see. How to play with that. I don't know what that is.
I don't know what's going on. What is that?
Is that some kind of glitch? Or I don't know. That's kind of wild. It's very possible that the world has got a little bit of a glitch to it. I don't know. That's weird. It's really kind of hindering my progress here. So, just continuing to play with these. Now, time to head up a level here in the tree age or something. Forget it was Stone Age. I think that's what it is. Maybe the Stone Age, I think. So, okay. So, we are up very fascinatingly. We're up in almost like an Ewok village. Little Ewoks, you know, Warl Wicket, good old Warl Wicket. But we'll see what needs to be done here, you know, to get these puzzles done and. Yeah, it looks like somebody might have, like, started flipping over tables. Go flip a table, I guess. So, we make our slow progress through this area. Apparently, this poor cabin, too, has seen some time and wear. Someone had been flipping furniture over in here, too. Well, looks like this has not been inhabited for a very long time. Wait. Oh, a switch. Oh, I see like a windmill off in the distance. Well, that's neat. There's not really a lot to really kind of like commentate about. I mean, you're just sort of wandering to and fro, just finding switches and, you know, flicking those switches, you know, it's to make progress. And hopefully, Glenn and Curly Joe will be back and, you know, and of course, Milo will be back at doing the things he does. But for now, we must think. We're in a thinking man's game right now. Another very busted up cabin here. Very, very, very busted up. Yeah, well. So, let's see. Well, this is a bit different here. Oh, it's another elevator. Well, let's go down. Or not. Oh, well, we go down the spiral staircase. That's a little more exciting, actually, just being in an elevator. Open this door up. Oh, make our way down this way, that way. And we're back to having the glitchy blue screen in front of us. That's, it's never good. Back up the stairs here. Let's see, going up nice and slow, I guess. Now we go down the elevator? Is that okay now? That is okay now. And we're going up. Let's see. Okay. Now up in the nice high treetops, you know, I can imagine the air must feel nice and crisp and good, you know, just like being at a good natural park, you know. Let's see, I go into this very beautiful, lavish room. This is very, very nice. Let's see here, we got a dagger and some ginger ale, I would suppose. Let's see here. Oh, we got a red page. And more stuff. Of course, that red page helps us to progress. Let's see here, then. Note, vote access. Very plain view on mist. An axis and whatever. Sort of a sink. More ginger ale. There's sparkly water, I guess. So we'll make our way back over here. We have the red page now. I think that should be the go. What's this? Foreign language. What's this? Of course, folks, I don't really got the sound on. I didn't have the sound on, and there's, it just said foreign language, so I'm taking that we wouldn't have understood that. As you can see, this is not the original Myst. The original Myst used full motion video, which was, in my opinion, better than just using these digital faces, you know. But, and of course, now it's playing more foreign language. Yes, so what is going on? It's a blue page. I hope I pushed the right button, brother. A very interesting device you have here. I'm not erasing anything important, am I? Remember, he is preparing to take only one page, my dear brother. As you can clearly see, these two brothers are villainous, and So I think we pretty much have successfully gotten through this level, I would assume. I don't know if there's any other pages, so we'll head back down and probably need to take each page and put them in the book. So, let's see. Head back down. So, down the spiral staircase here.
It kind of makes me a little bit dizzy.
And always remember, bring your blue arrow with you. I still haven't figured out what that says. Yeah, I don't understand that at all. Apparently, he still has. Apparently, still got to sort of work on this puzzle here with these pipes. That's apparently we're Roto-Rooter, apparently. Well, let's see. Gotta develop a little bit of a bridge here. Okay. So we are walking around here. Of course, after getting the red and blue pages, you would think we'd be done here, but apparently we weren't. But there must be more. Okay. There must be something that wasn't done right or something. Okay. Walking our way through here. And make sure to bring up your blue arrow with you. Never want to leave him all by himself. He might get lonely. That's right, blue sign. Don't worry, I'll get you through all this. You'll be nice and safe and sound. Here on the bayou. I assume they haven't patched that. They were probably like, how do we figure that out? They're like, oh, I don't really care. And they're like, yeah, we don't really care either. They'll play it anyways. They could just complain about it in the review section. Is that going to do the trick? That does the trick. Another elevator ride up. Now we are in the upper levels here, and there's another book. And take it takes us to a new level. It does. Oh, it takes us back to the library. Of course, now we gotta put the pages in. Huh. Well, let's see. What should we do now? I guess we're going to be doing... We are going to be doing another age here, I guess. And back to the library here, I guess. See what we're gonna do here. I really like this hallway here. It's just very relaxing. Now we gotta head up and we gotta do the thing again. We got to select a different area using this tower, take the coordinates, and that'll take us to each area. You can see a pattern. How we do that? 240, 221. And that's really the way the whole game is. You go to each section. You once you have the coordinates, you put those coordinates in, and that's the pattern. Of course, I remember Fredris H. He would always tell me about patterns. Always the importance of patterns in video games. We head back down here. And now you notice this clock tower here, and we're going to actually set that up. Set the dial hands to where we need them to be. Yes. Let's see. Is that exactly where I need it to be? Maybe not. Let's see. Yep, there we go. We got a bridge coming up that worked. Of course, you would be kind of thinking yourself, couldn't you just swim across that? That doesn't seem that bad, but I guess it's the. I guess what that's not the premise of the whole thing. You're supposed to use the puzzles and stuff, but Fred always talked about Bethesda games. He always would say, you're used to just doing whatever you want. So, let's see. I remember this from one of the books. So, messing with the gears, just getting everything just right. Oh, we're heading back to the center of the island. Still very beautiful out. We don't really have weather patterns here. So we gotta devote the time to these puzzles, because I really don't think I could ever leave here until I solve all this. And well... See here, there's another page. Oh, yep. It unlocked another age. So we're gonna do that. Oh, it's very beautiful here. Another puzzle here. Well, the show, I will let you know, ladies and gentlemen, is almost done.
Oh, no. Oh, no, I mean, you gotta wait a whole week. Oh, Jamie, oh, no. Oh, no. A whole week? Well, it seems so long.
Oh, but this room is splendid. Oh, look at this. It is wonderful. Just absolute wonderful craftsmanship. It's a shame that we have to end it here at this, because this is beautiful. We could just be here forever, you know? You gotta take a picture of this, because this is gonna mean something. And let's see, you've got these stones here, you've got this portrait, these beautiful portraits. Got this little wooden guy here. This is clearly a puzzle. And the Emperor Napoleon, I actually have a t-shirt with him on that. I actually have a t-shirt with that picture. And we got ourselves another page, a red page. So each level has a red page and a blue page. And then it has, of course, a warp back. And, see, Cirrus, your greed sickens me. Your desire for wealth and plunder is never satisfied. I will instruct my subjects not to pay your new tax. And you knew that that is. And I will see you all next show. Hopefully we get through this together.